Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another spherical coordinates problem, and we're going to be converting these spherical coordinates here, 3, 1/2 pi, or pi over 2, comma pi, to rectangular or Cartesian coordinates. So the formula that we're going to be working with for these spherical coordinates is the following. All we really have to remember for a problem like this when we're just converting the coordinates is that our spherical coordinates are going to be given to us in the order rho, phi, or phi, however you pronounce it, theta. Normally with rectangular or Cartesian coordinates, we're given x, y, z. In spherical coordinates, it's rho, phi, and theta. And all we have to do is remember which one is which and plug them into the correct spots in our three formulas here. So when we do that, we're going to get three equations for x, y, and z. You can see we're going to plug in 3 for rho, here, here, and here. We're going to plug in 1/2 pi for phi, here, here, and here, and we're going to plug in pi for theta, here, and here. And that gives us these three equations for x, y, and z. Now, in order to evaluate these equations, to simplify them, we're going to need to look at the unit circle here. So let's go ahead and take a look first at our x and y equations. You can see that we have sine of 1/2 pi in both of them, right? Sine of 1/2 pi. We also have cosine of 1/2 pi here. So if we jump over here to our unit circle and we're looking for the angle 1/2 pi, which is the same, right, as pi over 2, we can see that pi over 2 is right here on a unit circle. That's where our angle is equal to pi over 2. So whenever we're using the unit circle, if we're looking for cosine of an angle, we're looking at the x-coordinate at that point, which here is 0. If we're looking at sine of the angle, we're looking at the y-coordinate, which here is 1. So remember that cosine of pi over 2 is going to be 0, will be 0, because x is equal to 0, and sine of pi over 2 is going to be 1. So if we jump back over here to our equations and we bring these in here, we can see sine of pi over 2 is the y-coordinate, which was 1, so we plug in 1 here. Sine of pi over 2 again gives us 1 here. And then cosine of pi over 2 was 0, x was equal to 0 along the y-axis there on the unit circle, so we plug in 0 here. The only other thing we have to look at is the angle pi, because we're looking for cosine of pi and sine of pi. So if we head back over here to our unit circle, we can locate the angle pi right here. So we see that this is the angle pi, and we're looking for cosine there. Cosine, remember, is the x-coordinate, so that's negative 1. If we're looking for sine of the angle, that's the y-coordinate, which in this case you can see is 0. So cosine of this angle will be negative 1, and sine of this angle will be 0. So if we head back over here to our equations, cosine of pi will give us negative 1. So you can see we've multiplied here by negative 1. And sine of pi is 0, so you can see that we multiply here by 0. So that's how we use the unit circle to grab these values, and now it's just really easy simplification. 3 times 1 times negative 1 gives us negative 3. 3 times 1 times 0 gives us 0. And 3 times 0 gives us 0 for x, y, and z respectively. So finding the rectangular or Cartesian coordinates, we simply put all three of them together, and our rectangular coordinate will be negative 3, 0, 0. And this is exactly equivalent to the spherical coordinate 3 pi over 2 pi. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video.